Pond hockey. Many call it hockey the way it's supposed to be played. Outdoors in freezing temperatures, using a shovel instead of a Zamboni to clear the ice. Newsline 9's David DeGuzman introduces us to the game that goes back to its roots.
It's just the best, purest form of hockey.
A frozen lake in Eagle River has been transformed into a hockey lover's paradise. Here, players gather to compete on ice 20 inches thick, all for a keg that's been transformed into a trophy and a chance to take your team photo in front of an inflatable beer bottle.
We have people from 30 different states here, so they come into this small community and they love coming here, and it's the journey.
Some journeys are longer than others, like the Orange County Outlaws, who came all the way from California and have played together for 35 years.
We all grew up playing pond hockey. This is our fifth year in a row coming here. And the first year we were here, we walked out and couldn't believe what we saw. And we made a pact that we'll always come back. We'll be here every year.
Well, there are a couple of differences between indoor hockey and pond hockey. For one, the ice isn't as smooth, and the net, it's a lot smaller.
The ice isn't as good as far as passing the puck. Skating, it's a lot harder. The puck bounces everywhere.
But the novelty and the camaraderie of outdoor hockey is worth the trouble, and winning helps too. The PowerVar team from Chicago captured one of the over 50 crowns, proof that you're never too old for a timeless tradition.
It's great. This is our third year playing up here. It's always a lot of fun. The first year we made it to the semifinals. Last year we left a little earlier, but this year we're taking it all and it feels great. We played hockey together, some of us, for 40 years. I mean, the ice is a little different from what we're used to most of the time, but it's great fun.
Lannert says the trick is to keep playing, something they'll keep doing here on Dollar Lake. Reporting in Eagle River, David DeGuzman, Newsline 9 Sports.
I find it so cool that people from all over the country have annual traditions that they upheld every single year right here in Wisconsin.
Need to see David giving us the up close and personal view of
that's
the net
right
as well.
Yeah. Love that.
Thanks, Lauren.
Our athlete of the week has been curling since he was 9, and his Wausau West team has yet to lose this season. But Matt Sanquist's biggest achievement might just be helping to turn the new Wausau Curling Center into a reality. Matt Sanquist helped Wausau West win a state title freshman year and recently led the Warriors to another TG Bonchville championship. But nothing beats helping to build a curling center.
But as soon as September 1st, as soon as school started, I was down here just about every day after school helping.
From creating the ice to setting the rings, the Wausau West senior, along with his teammates, spent countless hours building the center.
We would be down here till 1 in the morning sometimes, just making sure that this ice field was just perfect. And it was a lot of lost hours of sleep during that.
Construction delays forced Sanquist to wait a month longer than expected to finally compete. But he remembers throwing his first rock on the new ice.
It's like opening a present for the first time. You're curious to see how it all works.
At the beginning of the year, he was very excited just to get out on the ice because they spent such a long time working on the stuff. He was really excited to just get out there and curl.
And the result, he says, is perfection.
The floor here is laser leveled. It's perfect, so you don't have to worry about flooding more water in other spots and then having uneven ice and making the rock. You look at this one right here, it's going to probably curl right into that yellow rock and hit it just perfect. We went from the worst curling club, one of the worst curling clubs probably in the nation, to now, I would say hands down, probably the best and one of the best in the world.
He wants to start something new and develop some new traditions here.
Traditions like winning, which is all Sanquist and the Warriors have done since the center opened. Matt Sanquist, your Newsline 9 Athlete of the Week.
Katie Spencer loves skiing so much that the Wausau West senior spent 7 months working at a grocery store last year just to buy a new pair of skis. And as David DeGuzman explains, the senior and captain of her team has come a long way, considering she didn't always spend much time on the slopes.
Katie Spencer remembers when she first skied down Granite Peak at the age of 7.
I thought it was really fun. Like, I had never been skiing before, and I was just like being fun with my sister and my dad, and like I picked it up really fast, and my sister had to go to ski school and I didn't, so I was really proud of myself.
Her passion for skiing was sparked once she learned that the sport runs in her blood.
I learned that my aunt and my dad both skied in high school, and my family was like, oh, join the race team.
My aunt was the captain of her team. Yeah, they were pretty excited and happy because I was like continuing the legacy, I guess you could say.
When she first came in as a freshman, I wasn't too sure what to expect. I mean, she seemed very athletic at the time, and sometimes you don't know how it's going to transfer over onto the ski hill. And it was a tough transfer at first. It took a while to get there, but you know, because of that athleticism, she was able to transfer that over to become a very good skier over the course of 4 years.
Spencer had never raced before her freshman year. 4 years later, she's now a conference champion. But the Warriors captain says she still freaks out before a race.
Katie Spencer coming through the finish line, bib number 581.
Usually it's just like, okay, where do my skis point? And then where's less good I can see? And like, then I just go, and then I kind of like forget to breathe and stuff when I go down.
You forget to breathe?
Yeah.
She has one competition left in her high school career, the state championships in lacrosse. One more chance to forget to breathe as she hits the slopes. Katie Spencer, your Newsline 9 Athlete of the Week. David DeGuzman, Newsline 9 Sports.
That's so amazing that she had never skied competitively before her freshman year, and now she's the captain of her team and just doing amazing on the slopes.
And looking good out there.
That's right.
Obviously has skills.
That's right, just a natural.